and I welcome you back to Cricket Diaries by Crick Heroes. आज हमारे साथ आए हैं एक ऐसी प्लेयर जो already 9000 plus runs कर चुके हैं with remarkable strike rate of 152 और बहुत सारे matches जिता चुके हैं. Let's welcome Rajesh from Hyderabad to know more about his journey so far. Hi Rajesh, how are you doing?
I'm doing very good. Thanks for asking. How are you?
Good. Very good. So please tell us, where did the journey of cricket started? When did this become like your passion?
Right from the childhood, I have seen my brother playing cricket. So I started playing cricket alongside him. So it started from like 4 years, 5 years of my childhood. So since then, I'm very passionate about cricket. I used to play cricket in Delhi, with my friends in the school, in the colleges. That's how I started playing cricket. And now cricket is a very passionate game, and I'm very passionate about it. It is a part of life, is what I feel.
That's really great. And this whole journey from since you were 5 years old, I'm sure there must have been multiple cricketers have inspired you in this whole phases of life so far. Which are the ones?
Inspirations have been changed from my childhood to now, because there are different generations of players I have seen. Like when I was young, my dad and my brother used to like Sachin Tendulkar, Azharuddin, and these guys. And now, as I started growing up, I have seen Sachin more. And then once Sachin retired, I have started seeing Rohit Sharma, Virat Kohli, Yuvraj Singh. I personally like Yuvraj Singh a lot, and then Rohit Sharma. And now I like Rahul as well. Yeah.
Yes, that's great. And also, I went back and I saw your statistics and I realized that you have a 190 unbeaten 190 and also I saw the best bowling performance for 549. So who is it that you were inspired to give such amazing performances? That's 1 second. Are these the most memorable moment in your journey, or has there been any other moment that you will always go back and remember?
I have scored 155 in a T20 game. That is a very memorable moment. And 190, I have also scored 190, but that is a one-sided game. But 155, which I've scored, is a very good game. So I personally like 155 more than 190, and I'm more of a batsman, so I like scoring rather than taking wickets.
But with a batsman who also is taking 549 wickets, I think everybody is wanting you in the team.
Obviously, yeah. We play a lot of matches in the weekends and sometimes in the weekdays as well. There are 3 slots in which we play matches in Hyderabad. There is a morning slot which starts at 7 o'clock and then 10:30 and then 2:30. We normally play 3 matches per day. So it's like we play 3 T20 matches in a day more often than or not. Like, so we play a lot of tournaments. We almost cover all the tournaments that we play, and the quality of cricket that is being played in the recent days has been increased a lot. So we are enjoying the way we are playing cricket, and Crick Heroes is actually... Crick Heroes has set a benchmark for everybody, so that, Crick Heroes is a wonderful app and everybody has started scoring in Crick Heroes, so that everybody has stats now, like how many runs you have scored, like what strike rate you have scored. Everybody has statistics now. Like, you go to your home and you show your parents, your friends, your kids, like, I have scored this much today. This is what I have scored. These are the regions where I have scored. Like, it was never before like that. Earlier, it used to be on the paper scoring, which you cannot express to others. And you say something and they cannot understand properly. But Crick Heroes has eased that out. And you guys are doing a very wonderful job. And I'm very happy that you have got a thought of actually developing an app which actually supports the young cricketers and also budding cricketers and all these people. It's not just only about the professional cricketers, but cricket is part of life for most of the Indians, is what I feel. So even I have friends who who is about 45, 50 years, and they play cricket and they have a lot of passion. And they, at the end of the day, they go to their home and they show their kids, I have bowled today, I have taken 2 wickets, 3 wickets. This is only possible just because of cricket. And you guys should be very proud of yourself.
Thank you so much. I humbly, feel on behalf of everybody in the team that we are feel very humble that, you as well as all your team members are actually being able to use most of the app. We could not have been able to do it if it was not, you all were not using it to your heart's content, and there wouldn't be any motivation for the team to actually create or make changes or make it better. So thank you so much for saying such wonderful words. I'm sure everybody will be very highly motivated.
Yeah, when there is something good, people will obviously start using it.
Yeah, thank you so much. And we couldn't have come to that point only if it was not all of you were using it. Also, this just makes me think of the next question, that looking at the statistics that you have achieved so far, do you have a personal target that you wish to achieve? Like, do you think, have you set a goal or something, or do you just take it like the way it is each day as it comes?
No, I don't take cricket professionally because I am already 30 years old and I don't think I can play professional cricket. But playing cricket eases your life. I have my own business. I have a lot of stress to be handled at the workplace. I have a lot of stress to be handled in the personal life. So cricket is something which eases life. Like, it is a stress buster for me. Like, whenever I play, whenever I enter a cricket field, I tend to forget everything. I enjoy the game. It gives me an immense happiness. It takes you out of all the stress you have, all the problems you have. So cricket is like a medicine. Like, it is a very good game to be played. So I love playing cricket. I don't have any personal goals, but I love playing cricket, and I'll play cricket until my body supports and I can be beneficial to the team, I keep playing.
Yes, and I think that's a very valid point. You know, already you have so many targets in your, like you said, in your career and your business and, everything. So it's like cricket could be the easy place not to have targets. I think that's a great way to look at it. And especially before an important match, is there any way that you normally prep yourself? Is there something that you do?
See, what I feel is, before an important match, pressure is something that bounces around you. So if you think a lot about the opponent team, or if you think a lot about the match that has to happen, that has to begin, that only gives you more pressure, and you get stressed out because of the pressure. What I feel, cricket is a mind game, and your confidence is something which you really need in cricket. So if you get pressurized, you will be short of confidence. So I always stay confident, and I don't take the pressure on. I take every game as a normal game. And if it is an important game, I try to concentrate more, but not take the stress or the pressure.
Very valid point. And just a fun question, that do you have a personal superstition, or do you have like a lucky charm that you carry that is, that helps you to win all those 190 or make those 190 not out and a 155 run? What is it that you do? Like, anything personal that is...
Normally I open the batting. So openers have a choice of doing the free throwdowns and knockings before you go. You pad up and then go place and knock, throwdowns, and then you go play on there. But I never play any throwdowns before the batting. I directly pad up, I sit, and whenever the umpire say it's the start of the game, then I'll straight go there, and then I'll hit it from the ball one. But I never play any throwdowns. That's a kind of a sentiment for me. If I play throwdowns, then I'll get out. So I don't play any throwdowns before the batting.
Okay, that's great. And I am sure the team also supports on that. Are you watching the IPL?
Obviously, yeah. IPL is one of the biggest thing to happen now. This point of time, yeah.
So any particular player that you're following this IPL?
I've been following all the teams and all the matches. Like, I have so many players that I follow. Every team, I have my favorite players, and if somebody's playing good, we follow them. Like, I like Rohit Sharma, and yesterday Hardik Pandya has played really well. Like, these kind of innings and all, we enjoy watching IPL. Yeah. I have a lot of favorite players.
Now that you named two players from the Mumbai team, so is it Mumbai Indians who are you are rooting for?
Yeah, Mumbai, obviously, because Sachin supports Mumbai and I support Sachin.
That's great. So, so now, thank you so much. I think we really appreciate that you took our time and talking to us. And I really wish that, you know, with the spirit that you're playing, with that whole ease and feeling relaxed, the way you're playing, and even then you have scored 9,000 plus runs. I wish a lot of people get inspired by that. Thank you so
much. I play serious. Whenever I play it serious, but I don't take the pressure. That's it.
I think that's a great tip. I think once if you be relaxed, we see that you've got so many runs. I'm sure that's a very valid tip that you're giving it to all. But thank you so much, Rajesh, for joining us today. It was such a pleasure to have this conversation with you.
Same here. It was a pleasure talking to you as well.
Yeah, thanks so much. And for everyone else, do join us back tomorrow again. We're going to come back with another star from the grassroots cricket. Till then, you take care. Bye-bye.